आज हमारे साथ मैडम गीता कोठापल्ली हैं, जो कि अराकू आंध्र प्रदेश से मेंबर ऑफ पार्लियामेंट है। अराकू भारत का एक ऐसी बड़ी कॉन्स्टिट्यूंसी है, दूसरी बड़ी कॉन्स्टिट्यूंसी है जहाँ से अकेली सांसद है। नमस्कार मैडम। सबसे पहले मैं पूछना चाहूँगी, आप पॉलिटिकल फैमिली से नहीं हो ना, आपने पॉलिटिक्स कैसे ज्वाइन किया?
पॉलिटिक्स ज्वाइन करने के लिए फैमिली इज नॉट इम्पॉर्टेंट। यू विल हैव टू हैव अ क्लियर इंटेंशन टू डू समथिंग फॉर द पीपल। आई फील दैट पीपल हु आर इंटरेस्टेड इन डूइंग पब्लिक सर्विस, पॉलिटिक्स इज अ वेरी गुड चॉइस ऑफ करियर, बिकॉज यू कैन डू अ लॉट ऑफ वर्क व्हेन यू एक्चुअली कम इनटू पॉलिटिक्स। सो आई हैव बिकम अ पॉलिटिशियन बाय चॉइस।
And you are serving the second largest constituency aapke paas hai, and there are a lot of problems, a lot of tribal, lot of health issues and other things also. To uske sath mein aapka central government ke sath mein kaisa talmel hai?
Actually this constituency Araku is the second largest constituency in India, and as you said, and after Ladakh, first is Ladakh and the second is Araku. And 90% of the population of Araku constituency are tribals, and it has been neglected. 70 years se bahut neglect hua, aur connectivity nahi hai, health issues hai, educational issues hai, rural infrastructure ka problems bahut hai. So from the very beginning of my career as an MP, I was very clear that I wanted to do something. पहले द मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट प्रॉब्लम इज ड्रिंकिंग वाटर। ड्रिंकिंग वाटर नहीं है, सो मैनी पीपल आर डाइंग एवरी ईयर बिकॉज ऑफ नॉन अवेलेबिलिटी ऑफ सेफ ड्रिंकिंग वाटर। सो इफ इंडिया कैनॉट प्रोवाइड इट सिटीजन्स बेसिक वाटर, रेस्ट ऑल इज द सेकेंडरी, रेस्ट ऑल कम्स आफ्टर दैट। बट फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल इफ पानी भी नहीं प्रोवाइड कर सकते तो फेल्यूर हो जाते। So I was actually concentrating on providing minimum amenities to the tribals, because I see an important quotation in Prime Minister's launch. You know, life is but travelled once. We will never know whether we will pass through this again or not. But when we are here, we will do our best. So every day in life, आज नहीं आता, आज आज ही पूरा होता है. So what good we have done? अच्छा कम क्या किया वो इट विल 100% इट विल रिमेन फॉर द रेस्ट ऑफ आवर लाइफ। वी विल हैव अ सैटिस्फैक्शन, यस वी हैव डन दिस। सो आई हैव कम इन टू पॉलिटिक्स, एवरीबडी हैज गॉट देयर ओन डेफिनेशन व्हाई दे हैव कम। आई हैव कम इन टू पॉलिटिक्स बिकॉज आई डिडंट वॉन्ट माई लाइफ टू पास अवे एज एन अननोन सिटीजन डूइंग नथिंग फॉर एनीथिंग। एवरीबडी, ह्यूमन लाइफ इज अ गिफ्ट ऑफ गॉड। सो भगवान ने मेरे को बहुत ब्लेसिंग्स दिया, अच्छा फैमिली दिया, अच्छा हस्बैंड दिया, अच्छा चिल्ड्रन दिया। सो एवरीथिंग गुड गॉड हैज़ गिवन मी। सो आई वांट टू गिव बैक टू द वर्ल्ड व्हाट गॉड हैज़ गिवन। सो दैट इज़ व्हाट इज़ माय रीज़न फॉर कमिंग इनटू पॉलिटिक्स। एंड फ्रॉम द वेरी बिगिनिंग दिस अप्रोच इज़ व्हाट आई एम एक्चुअली हैविंग टूवर्ड्स द कॉन्स्टिट्यूएंसी, बिकॉज people trusted me, they voted for me thinking that I will perform something for them. So yahi pura hona chahiye. We have to at least do whatever best we can do. Very little scope we have, we don't have a magic wand, sab kuch nahi kar sakte. Fir minimum amenities ke bare mein whatever I can do.
There's a one organization called Geetha, which is you only.
गीता का मतलब है जनरल एनवायरमेंटल एजुकेशन फॉर ट्राइबल हेल्थ एक्शन।
टेल मी समथिंग सोसाइटी, व्हिच इज योर सोसाइटी एंड यू डूइंग फॉर द सोसाइटी।
यस यस, आई हैव एस्टैब्लिश्ड दिस सोसाइटी इन 2007, मच बिफोर आई केम इनटू पॉलिटिक्स, इवन व्हेन आई वाज अ ऑफिसर इन द गवर्नमेंट। बट आई वाज अ नॉमिनल चेयरमैन एंड ऑल द अदर मेंबर्स वर डूइंग द वर्क। And this society used to operate only on whatever meager profits that my company was making. We never took any funds from anybody. So I was operating only because whatever I had from my companies, I was doing that. And why I established this society was, My father was the first graduate of agency area. उनका मन में बहुत ट्रैवल्स के लिए काम करने का एक डिज़ायर है, बट एज ही वाज इन सर्विस ही कुड नॉट डू व्हाट बेस्ट ही कुड डू, बट आफ्टर रिटायरमेंट ही वर्क्ड फॉर द ट्रैवल्स टिल द एंड ऑफ हिज लाइफ. ही डाइड एट 74. सो रिटायरमेंट के बाद वो 14 इयर्स कंप्लीटली ट्रैवल्स के लिए डिवोट कर रहे हैं. सो आफ्टर हिज डेथ आई वॉज बॉर्न एट अ वेरी लेट एज. So I was more associated with my father. My father always used to tell me, those who have got money can definitely survive, but do something for the poor tribals, do something for the poor people who need you. That will give you a lot of satisfaction. Do something for the people who don't know who you are. They should not be family, relatives and all. They should be somebody who actually needs your help. So for that purpose I established this society. And I have been supporting, every year I have been supporting 200 to 300 children to study in the society. And we are providing health awareness programs, health camps, and whatever small drinking water projects, bore wells, whatever we can do within the small purview we have been doing. And we have been expanding now right now. So many people are also now coming forward to saying that we also want to participate, we also want to do. So we have 2007-8 May, हम 10 एम्बुलेंसेस दिया, अभी भी काम कर रहे हैं. सो वी आर हैविंग अ वेरी गुड नेटवर्क इन द एजेंसी एरिया एंड वी हैव बीन डूइंग लॉट ऑफ सर्विस एंड दैट वाज नॉट एसोसिएटेड विद माय पॉलिटिकल करियर. दैट इज हैपनिंग इवन टुडे, इट इज हैपनिंग.
अब आप एमपी हैं और उसके लिए ट्राइबल्स के लिए सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट से आप क्या क्या मदद करेंगे? ट्राइबल्स की मदद के लिए, उस क्षेत्र को डेवलपमेंट के लिए सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट की जो स्कीम्स हैं उस स्कीम्स के तहत आप क्या क्या आगे करेंगे?
फर्स्ट थिंग इज ट्राइबल एरिया में कनेक्टिविटी बेसिक इशू प्रॉब्लम. कनेक्टिविटी प्रोवाइड करने के लिए PMGSY से डिपेंड होता है या NREGS में डिपेंड होता है. PMGSY बहुत, देयर इज अ लॉट ऑफ सैंक्शंस बट वो काम नहीं हो रहा है. एवरीथिंग इज कमिंग टू अ स्टैंड स्टिल बिकॉज ऑफ द प्रॉब्लम ऑफ दिस. एक कनेक्टिविटी बेसिक इशू है. सो वॉट इज हैपनिंग इज PMGSY में 2013 से वर्क्स नहीं हुआ. आई एम जस्ट परस्यूइंग दैट टू गेट इट डन. आई हैव ऑल्सो गॉट सैंक्शन ऑफ मोर देन 10 to 15 इम्पॉर्टेंट क्रूशियल रोड्स अंडर PMGSY. लिविंग दैट असाइड, NREGS कॉम्पोनेंट में भी ये कनेक्टिविटी हो रहा है. NREGS वर्क्स में हमारा कॉन्स्टिट्यूंसी रॉकी टेरेन है. रॉकी टेरेन है तो NREGS में कंप्लीट एंड लेबर कंपोनेंट यूज करके रोड्स बनाना बहुत मुश्किल है, बहुत टफ है. सो व्हाट आई डिड वाज आई वेंट एंड अप्लाइड, आई वेंट एंड गिव अ रिप्रेजेंटेशन टू द यूनियन मिनिस्टर सेइंग दैट, यूनियन मिनिस्टर फॉर रूरल डेवलपमेंट, देन इट वाज मिस्टर चौधरी साहब. आई गिव हिम अ रिप्रेजेंटेशन इन पंजाब में एक काम, एक मैकेनिक इक्विपमेंट यूज़ करने के लिए वो उन्होंने परमिशन दिया रॉकेट टेरेन में रोड्स बनाने. यही परमिशन मैंने हमारा कॉन्स्टिट्यूंसी में भी यूज़ किया और वो परमिशन दे दिया. सो वी कैन यूज़ सम सॉर्ट ऑफ इम्प्लीमेंट्स टू मेक द रोड, मैकेनाइजेशन टू यूज़ द रोड बिकॉज इट्स अ हिली रॉकेट टेरेन. So after that we were able to do good progress in the NREGS front. Not only that, during the in the educational infrastructure also we are able to concentrate on amenities. Previously children were sleeping on the floor. We had given them bunker beds, we are providing them facilities. Now RO plants have come up in the schools and we are giving them inverters and geysers. So all this for the educational infrastructure we are providing. Now I am planning to give digital classrooms. ये डिजिटल क्लासरूम्स के लिए मैंने कोल इंडिया को भी पूछा. आई थिंक आई एम गिविंग एम पी लैड्स, आई एम गिविंग मैचिंग फ्रॉम माई एम पी लैड्स एंड आस्किंग देम टू गिव अ मैचिंग ग्रांट. सो वी आर डूइंग दैट एंड वी हैव डन लॉट ऑफ प्रोग्रेस इन द स्वच्छ भारत ऑल्सो. वी हैव बिल्ड सो मेनी टॉयलेट्स एंड इट इज़ लाइक HPCL हैज़ कम फॉरवर्ड, NTPC हैज़ कम फॉरवर्ड टू सपोर्ट अस ऑल बिकॉज ऑफ द सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट इंटरवेंशंस. सो वी आर प्रोवाइडिंग गुड नंबर ऑफ, I think we have come to a saturation as far as schools are concerned. So other than that, we have opened so many PHCs and area hospitals now, hospitals, but still amenities are lacking and we still have to proceed. I have given around 26 ambulances from my MP labs. And previously, the agency, the constituency agency area, complete forest area was very dark. There was no lighting at all because Panchayat had no funds even to provide lighting. So now, after the union government's intervention, Panchayats are also having sufficient funds. Not only that, from my MP lads, I have given lighting to all the Gram Panchayats. And I have been trying to give what all are the very, very important roads or very, very crucial joints I am trying to bridge through MP lads. So, yahi coordinates karte aur hum aage chal rahe
hain. Industry, your area is so big, there are a lot of villages up here as well. वहाँ पे अभी तक कोई ऐसी बड़ी इंडस्ट्री आपके क्षेत्र में अभी तक नहीं पहुँचा आपकी कॉन्स्टिट्यूंसी तक. और मेरे ख्याल से आई हैव रिटन समवेयर कि यू आर अप्रोचिंग टू FDI आल्सो एंड पीपल यू आर अप्रोचिंग टू लॉट ऑफ अदर पीपल अदर इंडस्ट्री ग्रुप ऑफ इंडस्ट्री. सो हाउ मेनी ऑफ देम हैज बीन कन्विंस्ड बाय यू और दे आर अप्रोचिंग और दे आर कमिंग बैक.
यस, अ फ्यू. वी डोंट हैव मच ऑफ इंडस्ट्रीज देयर बिकॉज़ ऑफ द जीवो 1/17. Because it's all like scheduled area,
scheduled tribe area,
and except scheduled tribes, nobody can buy properties there, and they cannot establish there. But there is another scope wherein you can. There is a lot of scope to improve tourism. So there are a few people who have come forward to establish resorts there, hospitality division, so that you know, like Ooty convention halls and 5-star hotels, if they come up, automatically you know employment is getting generated. And because of that, and recently if you have seen, we have got a glass train. It was, I thought it will become a dream because we have been approaching this so many years, they have been saying, but nothing happened. So first meeting mein MP hone ke baad, first meeting mein I went and requested the PM about this Vista Dome coach. So the glass train has come and we inaugurated it and people are really enjoying that. And regarding the maintenance also, recently I approached Railway Minister. So that is also very good step for the tourism promotion. So Lambasinghe, now we are growing apples, dragon fruits. Dragon fruits is not grown anywhere in India, but we are experimenting there. And in Lambasinghe also, we are planning to come up with a huge medical tourism center. So that a lot of people there, because they have got this, there it is very rich in herbal medicines. So this traditional Ayurvedic. So we are trying to come up with a major health resort there. So these will definitely boost tourism and it will also create employment for the youth there. And not only that, some companies have already approached me saying that they want to come forward with the IT industry also. They asked for the land, which I said I will procure and give. If the government delays also, I will procure the land and give. Please come. So 2-3 companies have come forward. They want to take the students and they want to actually train them in the skills, use them for their office, and if they want, they'll also be sent outside to work. So 90% of the tribals, as far as my knowledge is concerned, they're not interested in going out. So once they are trained there, BPO can also come over there. So this is step by step and it will take time. But now one more important achievement is we have also progressed in connectivity, this digital connectivity. But still we are very, very, it is not completely up to mark. But previously it was almost zero because when I used to go into the constituency, my phone never used to work. It used to work just for 5 minutes or 10 minutes, nothing more than that. And inside interior area, nowhere the phone used to work. But now little by little we improved in the number of cell towers, connectivity issues. So now recently I approached Manoj Sinhaji and told him about this digital connectivity. He was telling the AP government has also come forward, but still there is a small there is a difference in between the union and the state government's plans. So they want to give for every village, whereas we want to give for the mandal headquarters. That's still the discussion is going on. So first of all, if the mandal headquarters gets the digital connectivity, you know, the digital connectivity is very, very important for the BPOs to work. So unless we get the connectivity, if the people are coming there and they are lost with no connectivity, nobody would like to stay there. Even today, that is the main problem. Physical infrastructure of doctors is not there. Because once they come into the agency, their life is cut off from the outside world. So that we, unless and until we provide them that sort of comfort there, that after coming there also, they will have the connectivity, they will have communication with the outside world, automatically we can get people to stay there. And not only that, this Indira Gandhi Open University of Madhya Pradesh, they also wanted to open an offshore campus. So I am discussing on that also. I'll have to wait and see how it goes ahead.
Jaise ki, there are schemes like Adarsh Gram Yojana, one of the prominent Prime Minister scheme. And you are in Andhra Pradesh. Andhra government is clubbed with the central government. आपको कितनी असिस्टेंस और कितनी फायदा मिल रहा है उसका, कि कहाँ तक आपको उसका वो है?
Under Sansad Adarsh Gram Yojana also, ODF we could do, Swachh Bharat we could do campaigns, and some roads I could get it done in NREGS, and some programs basically we could get this water schemes so that every household will get water directly. Except the small interventions, the major, if I have to talk about the master plan which I wanted to do for Sansad Adarsh Gram Yojana, for every village there is a requirement of not less than 50 crore. I am telling you about the minimum requirement. Maximum requirement, if we go, because the schools, the ashram schools there, they need the compound walls, the schools infrastructure has to be
increased. Everything is... It is attached with the Prime Minister's
Yojana. Yeah. Everything is again the money. So unless we get some grant from the government, okay, awareness, Swachh Bharat will do. But if you want to finally make it into a planned village, the thing is, first we have to have certain amount of money. I have used certain of my MP lands, but you know, this is a very big constituency, and if I concentrate on a particular place and don't give it to the others will get annoyed with me. So I had to divide my grant within the, because 38 mandals I have got. 38 mandals. 38 mandals is...
What are the population?
1142 villages, 38 mandals, 20,000 habitations, and the population is 21 lakh.
Very good.
Very good. So, to distribute 5 crores per year is like, even if I want to distribute 50,000 also, it is a peanut and nothing comes in 50,000. So, MP lands is definitely, it has to be increased, you know. And MP's expenses, everybody talks, MP's get so much of benefits, so much of salaries. Everybody shies off from talking. But I feel MP is getting a salary of 50,000. And somebody is circulating a message saying that MP is getting 15,000 telephone allowance. We never get any telephone allowance. There is no telephone allowance at all. We get only a SIM card which we use it only for the official purpose. And everybody pay their bill. As far as I know, MPs, if they have a private number, they pay their bill by themselves. We don't have any amenities, telephone amenities, that amenity, this amenity. And we get 50,000 salary and 40,000 constant salaries. That is the amount that we receive. And 15,000 for the station. That is the only thing. Total, in total, we get 1,09,000. And with 1,09,000, an MP cannot manage the constancy, neither her own self. Today's MNC is there, people, the media were talking about it also, they draw a big package. And I don't know why MPs are eyed so jealously that they are enjoying everything. In fact, we lose the private life, we don't have a private life, we don't have private time, we have to attend to the constituency work, we have to attend to the parliamentary work, which we need to do a lot of research. We don't find any, in every country for the research there is an amount that has been provided by the government. But India, no, we don't have anything. And for the paperwork to really attend to these meetings itself, the amount of travel we do, the amount of pressure we take, everybody in the constituency of 21 lakh population, everybody, if somebody is building a house, they come and ask for help. If they are making a wedding, they come and ask for help. There's so many obligatory duties every day an MP performs in their own life. Every MP, I'm not talking about myself, every MP. On an average, I think an MP spends not less than 5 to 10 lakh in a constituency per month. And I really don't understand where this money comes from. Somebody like me who have actually a family behind and who has a husband to support, I'm trying to somehow manage. But somebody who is actually dependent on this, they have to just leave their work, just go and attend parliament, sit at home, do nothing. Because if you are travelling in the constituency per day, the amount of people you have to feed, the amount of people you have to give food, it costs not less than 50,000 per day. For the cars, for the petrol, for the people.
Team.
team to travel. And every month we have to manage, I have to manage four offices because my constituency is in four districts. And I can't afford people to travel all the way to Visakhapatnam to come and see me, to come and give their representation at least. The office takes care of the representations. So four offices and four staff.
Definitely.
Four office staff. So all these things
we have to manage personally.
We have to manage personally, and this is not noticed by anybody. Everybody thinks an MP is actually enjoying their life. But I feel that there is no enjoyment at all. There is only satisfaction we are doing something for the people. It's not the enjoyment.
One last question with you. Like, you are as a young MP, first timer MP, and we see we are in 2017 and 2019 as a party. And you are in the party where I think in your
I'm
party.
I'm not in any party right now.
No, so you are alone.
I'm alone. I'm in.
You have left YSR.
I've left. I'm not with YSR since the time I won the election because they have humiliated me. They have done all sorts of nonsense.
You are a single MP.
I'm a single MP.
Single MP.
I'm just working so
most
for
most of the. Then I have to say again good wishes to you.
Thank you.
Let's join again and be an independent MP always. Thank you.
No, I feel very proud to be like this because it is. I have more liberty in working.
Was in the list of member of parliament, you name
it is YSR.
Yes,
yes, because I have not resigned to the party.
Okay.
But I have discontinued working with the party.
Good.
I have not resigned to the party. I have neither joined any party.
Yeah, basically, only you are working with this. I guess.
That's it.
We have just gone a small research on that.
Yes.
You see that only as a member of parliament.
I have, whatever I have done till now for my constituencies at my individual level and whatever good relations.